Today's rock is this, my volcanic bomb. I got this near Amboy Crater, kind of off of the 40, sort of near Barstow-ish. I actually previously talked about where I'd gotten this, which is Dish Hill, on my video about Bowen's reaction series and olivine. It's half of one, so you get that cross-section view of the inside of a volcanic bomb while also getting that really kind of classic projectile shape. Sort of looks like half of a football, so you can imagine it just going floop through the air. If you've ever watched the movie Volcano, or pretty much any good volcano movie, you're gonna get some volcanic bombs. They are projectiles of lava that, as the lava flies through the air, the outside shell cools very quickly, and that hardens and creates sort of an outer casing. The inside can still be molten, and that is what you have here. One thing to know about lava and magma is that the slower that it cools, the more crystals form. The faster that it cools, the closer to glass you get. It's what we would call very fine grain, so you can see there's no discernible crystals here. That's because it's an extrusive rock. It's a lava bomb, or it's a volcanic bomb. But the inside has a slightly different texture. You can see those air bubbles a little better that might have been forming from the air trapped or the gases trapped inside of the lava. So I love that you can actually get that little bit of differentiation of the different ways that this might have cooled and formed. Why was there a volcano out in the Mojave where I could get this volcanic bomb from? That part of the crust is actually undergoing extension. So that means that's being slowly pulled apart and thinned. You're relieving pressure on the mantle itself. And what ends up happening is you get something called decompression melting. So the mantle is pretty much solid. It moves plastically, which is to say it moves sort of like a fluid, but it's actually solid. It's weird. Because even though it's undergoing very high temperatures, the magma is also, and the contents of the mantle are also under immense pressure. And that pressure keeps it as a solid. So as you thin the crust, then all of a sudden, the mantle down here is still undergoing those very high temperatures, but it no longer has the pressure keeping it as a solid, so it melts, and then it flows upward, and that creates volcanoes, which then create volcanic bombs.